Good afternoon. This is David Baiada, the CEO here at Baiada Home Healthcare. Today is Friday, August 21st, and this is your weekly COVID-19 CEO update. Today, we're going to kick off with Nora Triola, as usual, to talk through a pretty sticky issue around symptom identification with the COVID-19 virus and how it collides with an issue that many of us deal with related to seasonal allergies. And so, Nora, why don't you jump right in and talk to us about the overlap in identification of symptoms.
Sure, David, and thanks again for allowing me some time to speak with our clinical team, who are doing a marvelous job caring for our clients. And we work very diligently to keep you all healthy and safe. And one of the things that we've seen is over time, the symptoms have continued to change. It was a bit easier when we started back in March and we had three little symptoms to worry about: fever, cough, and shortness of breath. And we know that those symptoms have expanded. We now know that there's a whole lot of symptoms around headache, fatigue, sore throat, congestion in the nose. And as we've continued through the pandemic, we're now into spring and summer, and our allergy season is kicking up. And what we're finding is that when we interview those individuals that begin to develop symptoms, we often hear you report to us that, gee, I thought it was just a little bit of an allergy. Thought that congestion that I had and my little runny nose was an allergy. I didn't think I had COVID-19. And the reality was that some of you then have gone on and get tested and you are out actually positive with COVID-19. And so this is happening across the country. And in fact, the CDC is aware of it, and they've created this nice little tool for us to use so that we can help distinguish between allergies and symptoms of COVID-19. And so what you see here in the graphic are really the circle that identifies the common COVID-19 symptoms, and then the circle on the right that identifies the seasonal allergies. And there's really two that distinguish allergies. Those are itchy, watery eyes or sneezing. If you have any other symptom, we need you to think, have I been exposed to somebody? Do I possibly have COVID-19? And to monitor yourself and get tested, because that runny nose or that sore throat has proven to be more than a symptom of allergy and actually a symptom of COVID-19. So we want to keep you safe, keep you checking yourself. When you see any of those in the middle, cough, shortness of breath, headache, sore throat, you know, congestion, which, you know, you might associate with allergies, don't think allergies, think COVID first, and then follow up with what you're supposed to do, which is to monitor those symptoms, speak with your primary care physician, and consider testing. It's only for sneezing and watery, itchy eyes that I say think allergy. Those two symptoms alone. So hopefully that helps keep you safe, get you through the seasonal allergy season and through COVID-19 safely. Take care and thanks for all you do.
Thanks, Nora. This is a hard one. I appreciate your continued guidance to create clarity and support for all those out trying to figure all this stuff out, myself included. I want to wrap up with our common and favorite issue around PPE. This is some recognition of Tina in Hawaii in our skills lab, getting used to her face shield, which, you know, as I've mentioned on prior updates, is really just such a difficult thing that so many of our clinicians and our clients and their families are grappling with every day. We're trying to build and maintain an intimate relationship where we're inside someone's home, helping them in a time of need. And we have this piece of plastic standing between us and our client, and particularly in instances where it feels safe without it, right? And it's just this added thing to worry about. And I have empathy for and really admiration for all of our clinicians out there that are adapting to these changes week over week to ensure that, that they stay safe and that their clients and families stay safe. I'll also make mention that the background here that Tina is looking out at during her skills lab is not a painting. It is the actual view from the skills lab in this Baiada office in Hawaii. It sure beats the view from the office that I usually spend time in of a beautiful parking lot. And so thanks to Tina, but really thanks to each and every one of you out there that's navigating all of these PPE challenges each and every day. Nora, anything else to chime in on this issue?
David, thanks. Actually, there are two things that I wanted to chime in. Tina, thank you so much for modeling that safety precaution, because your mucous membranes of your eyes are the place, along with your nose and your mouth, that the virus can enter. And so we want to make sure those are protected, and you can protect them with goggles too. So we have goggles. If goggles would be more comfortable, don't be afraid to order those from Global Support Center or 4300, as I sometimes call it, and you can get goggles for yourself. But we're also really trying to update some of our photos and make sure that we are demonstrating good use of PPE. So we'd love these photos. And I know that I've challenged you before to be competitive and send your photos in or send your ideas in, and you respond in spades. So please go ahead and send us those photos of our clinical teams out in the field modeling good PPE. And we'll be able to use those for all sorts of good things going forward. So send them on in. And thanks again for all you do. Back to you, David.
Thanks, Nora. Appreciate the guidance. Thanks to Tina and to each and every one of you, just like Tina, that's adapting on the fly, being creative, flexible, and determined to ensure we keep you safe and keep your clients safe. We'll see you next week.